I don't want to tell anybody how they should live, but at the same time, my research for people living successfully on prana, what I found, everybody meditates in their way. You know, whether it's Buddhist meditation or whatever, they all put themselves into a period of silence where they can really feel the love of the Divine One inside and listen to its voice. And really seeking to know that higher aspect of themselves. Everybody seems to pray in their own way, whether it's a prayer, my favorite, which just says, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, which is a good prayer, or however they do their heartfelt interaction with the universal field. Everybody has come to understand that thoughts create reality, that whatever you focus on becomes real. So they've come into an understanding that when we focus on looking for the divine in all, we find that. When we focus on looking for the divinity inside, it reveals itself. So people have started to reject limiting programming, limiting beliefs that they've accepted from genetic influences, from environmental or cultural influences, because from the moment somebody's born, you're programmed. You're programmed by your parents, you're programmed genetically, culture, school, media, things you read, movies, music, programming, all the time. So people in this field have understood the power of giving ourselves permission to be limitless in our thought forms and our programming, understanding how thoughts create reality. So people meditate, they've had experience with prayer, the positive benefits of prayer, they've understood the power of mind in creation of reality. All of them at some point have intuitively lightened up their diet, gone from eating denser things, junk food, toxic foods, to lighter, 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 more raw, more fresh, healthier food over a period of time. Everybody at some point has understood that the body is a temple, and so it needs to be treasured and honored and exercised and made strong, doing yoga or tai chi or qigong or dancing or something that makes the cells of the body sing and be flooded with energy and feel alive, and the endorphins of the brain to, you know, pump better and more powerfully. Everybody has committed their life to service. You know, selfless service, just to give to people every day because we can, without any thought of reward. And this is a big part of this. You know, everybody I find who can do this successfully is a very compassionate human being who wants to be of help, not to save the world or be a hero, but just help because we can, not for thought of reward, not from ego. Everybody involved in this has understood the value of silence. You know, when we shh and we listen and we watch and we observe and we stand back and we just really experience the power of silence. So much wisdom in the field of silence. And to take that into nature and really absorb the energy of nature, there's nowhere more that you experience the beauty of creation than in the natural world. You know, on the mountain, in the beach, with the animals, wherever, everybody gets that sense of wonder, watching a sunset or seeing an innocent baby gurgle or laugh or these natural phenomena. So meditation, prayer, programming, a lighter vegetarian diet. Most people have had long-term vegetarianism experience. Exercising the body, service, time in silence in nature. And the last one is singing. You know, singing with devotion, singing for the joy of life, singing positive song, working with sacred chants and mantras and just devotion. Because as soon as you start to sing with love, devotion and appreciation, straight away that tunes the emotional body to the heartbeat of the Divine Mother's channel of love, in my words. You know, they say that Mother Mary is the queen of the angels, and that the angels' gift to humanity is music. And every culture, every religion, to some degree, are open to the reality of the angelic realms. And everyone I know, cultures generally, nearly everyone, love music. And you can feel the power of music. You can be feeling sad and depressed or whatever, and you put on some beautiful, soothing, classical music or something you love or some natural music, and it transports you. You know how people have the most sublime experiences with music? So music really touches us and tunes us. And somehow, The magic of these eight things transforms your energy emanations, because these eight things together tune us physically, emotionally, mentally, and spiritually, so that we access more deeply the field of love inside us, around us, and set up a stronger magnetic attraction of prana and chi and the elements that we need to free us from the need to take physical food. And that's kind of where I got to in my research.